not believe a word I say. I'll just get on to Vast Resources. It's a little bit unusual company. It's like, I can't stand on the side because of the controls in here. Vast is a rather unusual name listed company. We've gone from an explorer to producer in quite a short period of time, and also unusually we're in two different jurisdictions that not only are two different countries, but they're on opposite sides of the world. It was through various circumstances. It started out as an exploration company in 2005, focused in Zimbabwe on gold and at the time nickel that then ended up being diamonds. And in 2015 became a producer in both Zimbabwe and Romania. And currently in Zimbabwe we're involved as a minority shareholder in our formerly discovered Pickstone-Peerless Mine. And now we're involved also in the Eureka Mine. So we're very happy to say that we've got one operational mine and one other mine that's coming on screen probably in the next 9 to 12 months realistically. 6 months is a little bit presumptuous. However, we are still continuing our exploration activities in Zimbabwe, and we're looking at further opportunities. We actually haven't stopped looking in Zimbabwe. So we're quite excited that Zimbabwe has opened up now, and we're taking another look at further Zimbabwe as an investment destination due to the last regime. And the elections come out in July. In Romania, we have an operational mine there at the moment, which we also acquired in 2015. We started off with 15.1%, and in 2016-2017, we acquired the other 49.9%. We've taken it from a loss-making mine that was a former state mine that was closed, then reopened, then it had a different operator that we acquired from, and they never managed to get the balance right, and due to our local team and our overseas team working together and creating value, we've now taken that out up to a profit centre whereby we're extracting copper and zinc separately and a little bit of gravity-fed gold, but very small. But what's quite interesting is you can see from the time we went from 2015, we started to generate revenue in 2016, that also the revenue almost tripled or did more than treble in 2017. And we'll see that natural progression as soon as the financials come out, the audited results will come out later on, probably around August, September. And we're constantly looking at expansion in both jurisdictions. So we're actively working at new exploration targets, new acquisitions in both Zimbabwe and Romania, and it's actually going quite well for the company at the moment. So further to what I talked about just before, I tried not to read off the slides, but this first part's a little bit interesting. So in Romania, we've now got the Manaila project, which when we took over, just to give you a little bit of the background, we had a 300,000 tonne resource. We knew there was more. We took that in 2016 to a 1.2 million tonne resource, and the last job that we completed late last year takes it to about 4.6 tonnes, with another 15 million tonne further potential subject to further exploration. But the historical data in Romania is actually quite solid, and we've been very lucky in seeing that what we had from the historical data in these brownfield areas, the correlation to what we're finding after drilling and jorking is very close. So we're very confident that any of the brownfields that we attack in Romania, we will see the results from the historical data. And I'll go across further down to the longer term. We've also managed to stake claim on two fairly large historical copper mines, which was an exploration target of the former state company, Remin, which was